my privilege to be able to speak this evening. Hopefully I do better tonight than I have some of my announcements in the forum this past year, but I'm not going to make any promises. Today, we begin an adventure. Our 4 long years at this institution, and the many leading up to it, have culminated to the one document we received today, our diplomas. Or rather, the diploma covers we're about to receive. But with that diploma, many doors and opportunities are just now opening for us, whether it be employment or higher education. But it is here, with these many options, that we can choose our own adventure. Do you all remember the Goosebumps stories and the other Choose Your Own Adventure books from our childhood? For those of you who don't, each book starts with a few pages that set the scene, introduce characters, and begin a basic plot. But there's where the fun begins. We, as the readers, get to choose what the characters do in the story. For example, we could either choose option 1 and get on the spaceship and turn to page 5 to continue that story, or we could choose option 2 to be a little more rational and tell our friend about the spaceship we just happened to stumble upon, and continue that completely different narrative on page 7. Each branch in the story would lead to more branches, and depending on the choices we made for the characters, we would experience only one of various plots and endings the story had to offer. Well, we are presented with many choices like this now that we are older. For example, many of us have chosen to attend a college or university this coming fall. This is not our only choice, but for the sake of the majority, it's one we'll continue to explore on our own page 3. Well, we wouldn't be going to college if we weren't continuously emailed about forms that need to be filled out, documents that need to be submitted, and fees that need to get paid. Now it's time for a tricky decision. We're going to go with choice 1. Select someone we already know to be our roommate and potentially jeopardize the relationship as we plan to live together. Or choice 2, take a gamble and have the college assign us a random roommate, possibly someone who's going to watch us while we sleep. Or even choice 3, continue living at this thrill ride of a town and commute to our school. So which will it be? Obviously, for the sake of time, I'm afraid we can't go through every possibility together, because it's clear that many more decisions are to come. Should we go for a higher degree or start our job search? Should we invest in our old buddy's risky business venture or apply for the 9-to-5 office job with a 401k head? Should we stay single and focus on our own development or settle down with a spouse to start a family? I mean, each one has its pros and cons. How are we to know which adventure is the best adventure for us? In truth, it does not matter which of these options we take, simply that we take each one with passion and enthusiasm. We cannot wait around endlessly for what seems like the perfect option. We cannot apathetically put the book down and conclude our adventure will not continue. We cannot read further for both decisions and then go back and decide which we would like to take. It was Winston Churchill who said, "Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." In order to achieve a successful ending, we must simply turn each page of our adventure confidently, ready for whatever plot twists lie ahead. Some people will say that these were the best years of our lives, but I hope, with all my heart, that they are wrong. Sure, we had some great times. I will never be able to thank Mrs. Pantaleo enough for the fruit snack gummies she saved for me at the blood drives. And I will always cherish the memory of everyone making fun of me for that one time I messed up the Pledge of Allegiance. There are so many memories and so many people I wish I could take the time to acknowledge them. But there are even better times to come. Who reads an adventure book and says the beginning was their favorite part? This is only the start, and I can't be the only one who plans to be wildly successful and have a great time doing it. Each of our adventures is unique, each is important, and each is worth taking, I promise. I wish each and every one of you good luck on your own adventure. Congratulations, class of 2015, and thank you. It is also my honor to announce the senior class gift, a new podium, or technically a lectern, as Ms. Siegel taught us. We hope it will be of use to the school for many years to come. Thank you.
Chairman Lane, members of the Board of Education, Mr. Augustine, and Mr. Batista, First Selectman Vavrick, my fellow Monroe administrators, members of the faculty, parents, guests, and members of the graduating class of 2015. Good evening, I'm Joe Cobbs, the principal of Massac High School, and it's a privilege for me to be here to address all of you this evening. American business consultant Jim Collins taught me that good is the enemy of great. That is, when we become complacent with good enough, we lose the capacity to be great. But what's the difference between good and great? I guess the easiest way to describe it is with an analogy that authors Sam Parker and Mac Anderson use. Let's look at the difference between good and great in the same way that we would look at the numbers 211 and 212. What's the difference between these two digits? The obvious answer is one. But if you look at them the way Parker and Anderson do, you get a different perspective. At 211 degrees, water is hot. At 212 degrees, it boils. And with boiling water comes steam, and steam can power a locomotive. So what are the takeaways from this analogy? First, and we've heard it our whole lives, always do your best. More importantly, it is that little bit extra that you give of yourself, that one extra degree that makes all the difference in the world. I've had the pleasure over the last 4 years to serve as your principal, to watch you develop, grow, and mature. And tonight, I'm asked to pontificate a few words to you, to give you advice about the real world, life after high school. The truth is, you've been in the real world all along. This hasn't been a trial run, and you have performed with distinction. Quite honestly, this speech was started nearly 2 years ago when I was vacationing in Cape Cod and received a phone call from Mr. Batista urging me to check your CAF scores. Not only were they the highest in school history, but they placed Massac amongst the elite in the state. But to relegate this class to a bunch of test scores would be a complete disservice. You are scholars, athletes, artists, musicians, performers, dedicated service providers, and so much more. Your performance, whether it be in the classroom, in our community, on stage, or on the athletic field, demonstrates a pattern of excellence. The key now is to maintain that momentum and remember to continue to give that extra effort, that extra one degree to separate yourselves. We are fortunate to be here tonight with five staff members who have repeatedly given that extra effort throughout their careers. We enjoyed the friendliness and service given by our custodians, Bill Sciacca and Joe Finale, who always made sure that we had one of the nicest facilities in the state. As you met with your guidance counselors over the last 4 years, you were always greeted with a warm smile by Helen Esposito, who calmed the nerves of many a stressed student. Any student who is lucky enough to have Janet Clement for math has witnessed the professionalism and knowledge of a teacher that encourages and embraces greatness every day. And finally, if one degree is the little extra that we need to give in life, I don't know how many degrees above 212 we would consider Gene Warner. Someone whose love for social studies and education has motivated her to teach at Massac High School for 49 years. I would ask that all of you retirees stand and wave somewhere in the crowd and wave as you recognize that this evening. We wish all of them the happiest of years to come. I also want to take the time tonight to acknowledge those students who will be given an extraordinary amount of effort as they join the greatest armed services in the world. I would ask that each of the following students please stand when I call your name so we can recognize you for your service to our country. Jordan Anselmo, Anthony Chacho, Nick DiLorenzo, Brendan Ferris, and Steve Majewski. Regardless of where any of your paths lead, sustained and focused effort will always bridge that critical gap between good and great. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Massac High School, I wish to each and every one of you the happiness of a successful life, respect of your fellow human beings, and the love of your family. Mr. Augustine, I attest that these members of the class of 2015 receiving diplomas have met or exceeded the graduation requirements established by the State of Connecticut and the Monroe Board of Education. It is my pleasure to present them to you this evening.